The painting of a bone china vase is a long and fascinating process, involving a great number of sequences which flow into each other like the colors used. First of all, sketching in, using a markall or non-graphite pencil to compose the picture. There is great danger in using a graphite pencil because color can come from the graphite to mark the colors in the firing. The curvature of a vase produces three-dimensional problems which require particular treatment in the sketching in, altering the angles so that they appear correct when seen straight on. This will be seen much clearer in the colouring in sequences of the bridge. Preparing the colours for the first washing in with the addition of fat oil, aniseed and a minute touch of glycerin, you will know that they are ready when they are fluid and no longer tacky.
Thank you.
having completed the washing in and fired the vase again in the kiln at about 740 degrees, it is ready for its second application of colour. From here onwards, frequent firings are necessary to keep the colours clean and pure, so that they do not merge into each other and go muddy. As far as the number of firings are concerned, it's very difficult to guide, but it is better to paint fast and fire often. Otherwise, the painting will appear laboured. Get as much weight of colour as you can into the one firing. But you must preserve the highlights, and the quantity of the colour will flux away anyway in the firing. Thank you. The vase after the third fire. Painting in the sky, a touch of pink added will tone down the rawness of the blue. And then later, more detail can be added after further firing. Thank you. Green-brown is built up on the trees. Yellow is then stippled into the green-brown, which begins to put modeling on the trees, bringing it back almost to the original color. A loaded brush with white mixed with fat oil and aniseed is used to pick away the clouds. This is not so much adding white as softening and removing the blue. Sometimes the dry finger can be used to pull back to the white, a more positive way than using the edge of the brush. Into the kiln for its fourth firing. Now, after the fourth firing, much more weight can be added. Take extra time to paint around the garlands of flowers rather than paint over and pick out. This produces a much more professional job. Adding detail to the faces, this time with a very old favourite brush. This one is 25 years old and has given great service. Never throw your old brushes away. After two further firings, more weight of color is added.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.